All right, hear me out. When it comes to Notion, you don't know what you're doing. I mean, I don't really know what I'm doing most of the time either. But we're in this together, and I want to show you some things that you will now know after having watched this video. Isn't that the point of me making tutorials? When it comes to some Notion formulas, people don't realize that this stuff is actually very Excel-like. So for example, if I take this name and I open it up and I take this text example here and I do and this name, I can add a property that is a concatenation. So I can do a formula, and just like in Excel, you can do concat and then put text example or name and then comma text example and then end it. And then you can do name and this name. So then we do is we'd add another space between by going to the beginning of this one, adding a space there, and then you have an easy concatenation between things. You also have other ways to do stuff like concatenation and the spaces, but you can also convert things to numbers, which people don't know. So for formula here, we can take this date property right here and convert it to a number, or vice versa. So we do to number, you go edit, so we go to number, the name of the property that we're looking for. So that would be date functions, end it, and then this is the number that we're going through. So if we want to find the difference between two different dates, say, for example, you want to figure out what is Notion considered to be one day in Notion. So we do date, we can do date one, and click on this one, and let's duplicate this property. Just select the next date. Then what I want to do is take these two dates. So to number, go date one minus to number date in the second one. And then with here, we'll see that the difference is this. So this number gives me an idea of how much difference is between 2 days here. So what I was actually able to do because of this information was make a formula that essentially figured out all of this and subtracted different numbers together so that based on how many project SLA days someone would have, it would figure out whether a project was late or not. I couldn't subtract the different dates from each other, but if I subtracted the two number from each other, then it would work out. So then for this, if we have the final assets received on August 4th, it's due today based off the 2-day SLA, but if I change it here, it's on time. If I change it here, it's late. So you can see the different ways that something like that can help you. And then when it comes to recurring tasks, guys, you can use a Google Sheet to kind of bulk sheet it really easily. So if I go here and I want to add this here, so I'm take this name and I could filter it to show this. I've done this before already, but I'm going to redo it just to showcase. What you do here is with this first one is you go and you copy all of these into a spreadsheet. So then what you could do is basically take this after you paste it in and then also paste it in right here and then clear out one. So you have the exact same columns that actually had data in them. And then what you do is you'd figure out whether you want to do it daily, weekly, or biweekly. Just adding some numbers to it. So I want to do it weekly. If I copy this and just paste it as value, then I just drop that down here and I drop these down all the way too. If I copy this, go back here and highlight all the rows, press paste, it'll drop it in there and have the same name. Now, in order to get the pages to work, what you easily can do, select this cell right here, copy it, hold and go down, paste, do the exact same thing here. You could actually select multiple of these at once and select all the rows, paste. And then boom, I just made recurring tasks. I did this for 30 weeks. There's a lot of Excel-like things that you can do in Notion. And if you actually want to learn more about Notion or Excel or whatever, let me know in the comment section down below and click here to see how you can improve your productivity even more.